Nel nome del Padre, Figliolo, Spirito Santo. Amen.
Such a separation.
Now a special thank you to anyone who might be watching the recorded video that we post on the different video platforms. All of my videos are on BitChute and Rumble and YouTube. So whatever platform you are watching this on, I really encourage you to subscribe to that platform. And then please, after you watch the video, leave a comment. Share some thoughts that you have. We always love to hear those and, you know, interact with us. And you can do that if you subscribe. Okay, once again, I would like us just to take a moment to endorse ourselves, for if you're here at the Sunday gathering, for actually being here. Or if you're watching the video, just endorse yourself for finding it, for clicking on it, for opening your mind, and listening and watching. I don't ever expect anybody to agree with everything that I say. I just ask you to have an open mind and let the words and the thoughts wash over you, and then see what thoughts they trigger in you. My thoughts are my thoughts. I put them out there, and the guidance that you're going to get is probably going to be different than mine, might be substantially different than mine, but we're all involved in the same process of healing. And as I offer my thoughts, let your best thoughts come forward. I'm going to talk about forgiveness today. Actually, the title of my talk is Forgiveness is an Action. We need to actually do it. Every Course in Miracles student knows that forgiveness is important, that it's actually a key foundational issue in A Course in Miracles, spoken about over and over and over again. And it's actually a key idea in any Christian faith. Forgiveness is one of those core Christian ideas, and it's one of those core A Course in Miracles ideas. It actually might be part of an argument that A Course in Miracles is a Christian discipline, or at least related to Christian disciplines, has many things in common with Christian disciplines. Forgiveness is also very key to any kind of healing that A Course in Miracles is training us on. In fact, I believe that all healing is ultimately reducible to forgiveness, to some form of forgiveness. A Course in Miracles says, forgiveness turns the world of sin into a world of glory. Wonderful to see. So that quotation, of course, uses the word sin, but let us not forget that A Course in Miracles also says sickness is but another name for sin. So it's equating sickness and sin. So you could easily substitute the word sickness for the word sin that was in the previous passage. So forgiveness turns the world of sickness into a world of glory, wonderful to see. So through the practice of true forgiveness, we can turn this world that appears to have sickness all over it into a world of glory that is just beautiful, wonderful to see. So I choose to see a world of glory, and we all can choose to see a world of glory instead of a world full of sickness. And again, it is a choice. It's something we have to choose. We have to choose it every moment of the day. Every time we're challenged, and we're all challenged as we go about our day and interact with the world, We're all challenged. We see what appears to be issues and illness and sickness in one form or another, both in our own lives and in the lives of others. And we choose to see a world of glory instead. We choose not to see that sin, not to see that sickness. We have to forgive the perception, because it said forgiveness is what turns this world of sickness into a world of glory. So we have to forgive that sickness, wherever it appears to be. Doesn't matter where it appears to be, in our own body, in our own lives, in the body of our affairs, or in the body and the lives of others. Doesn't matter. It takes forgiveness. And forgiveness, as I said, is an action. It's an active process. Doesn't take talking about forgiveness. It takes practicing forgiveness. All the people of the world could be walking around with totally healthy bodies. So this is a bit of guidance that I got this week, and it clicked true to me. So it's something that I wanted to share. I shared it with my healing team, so I'm sharing it with you now. All the people of the world could be walking around with totally healthy bodies. But, you know, we don't believe that's true. And we have accepted the reality that frequent or chronic sickness is just the way things are. You know, it's just, you know, the way of the world. It's the way of bodies. It's the way of so-called life. People get sick and people have issues and problems. But A Course in Miracles, I believe, is guiding us to a different reality. And it is a reality where it doesn't have to be that way. There is no need for it to be that way. This is just the way that we have accepted that it is, but we do not have to accept that. We can reject it. We need to reject it. I reject it. I will not accept that that is just the way things are. I reject that idea. Of course, the pharmaceutical companies want us to accept that idea. They have a vested interest in continually putting out the message that illness is real and that chronic illness is a thing, and that maybe even a majority of the people have one kind of chronic illness or another. And certainly as we increase in years, our tendency to contract illness or to contract chronic illness is going to increase rather dramatically. But we don't have to accept that, and we can forgive that, and we can forgive that perception. So what does it mean to forgive sickness? I mean, a lot of people will say that they are going to do that, or they talk about doing that, and as I said, forgiveness is not talking about doing it. It's actually a process. It's actually an action, and it's an action that we need to take. It's not something that we need to talk about. It's something that we actually need to do. And while I find a lot of lip service being given to forgiveness, I don't know how many are actually doing it. First of all, thing you got to remember, if you don't do forgiveness on your own, forgiveness always involves connecting with the Holy Spirit. Always. Many people try to do forgiveness by themselves. The very fact that forgiveness is called for means you cannot do it by yourself. You have to join with the Holy Spirit. And there are four steps to forgiveness, that especially as delineated in the Song of Prayer pamphlet, which Reverend Elaine read from earlier. And the first step is you have to identify the misperception. So it doesn't mean not seeing the misperception. It means clearly seeing it. So you have to identify the sickness, the way it appears to you, and get that it is appearing to you that way, and then to identify that it's not consistent with God, and it's not consistent with your Christ self, and it doesn't have to be there. So that's step number one. And then step number two is then you offer that perception and all the attendant thoughts you have surrounding that perception to the Holy Spirit. And I want to stress something here right now. It's we offer it to the Holy Spirit. So there's a tendency, and I've succumbed to it myself. So I'm going to, this is my declaration that I'm going to start watching myself. There has been this tendency all throughout the community, the Course in Miracles community, to not say the Holy Spirit, to just say Holy Spirit, to connect to Holy Spirit. But I was searching the Course for quotes about the Holy Spirit, and I found out something very interesting. There are 714 references to the Holy Spirit in the original edition, and not one of them ever drops the. It's always the Holy Spirit. It is never just Holy Spirit. But yet we in the community tend to say Holy Spirit a lot, almost like that's the entity's name. We talk about Holy Spirit. He's second, you know, the second part of the Holy Trinity. So the Holy Spirit. But we say Holy Spirit like it's his name. But it's not his name, and he's not an entity that would have a name. It's more of a descriptive, identifying definition of what he is. He is the spirit of holiness that we all have. He is the Holy Spirit that we all share. It's not his name. So it should always be the Holy Spirit. When we see somebody that we know, we just say their name. We don't say, here comes the Reverend Tony. We say, here comes Reverend Tony. Here comes Diane. We just say the person's name. We don't say, here comes the Diane. So if we drop the, we begin to think of the Holy Spirit as a being with a name. And I believe we're supposed to be broader in how we conceptualize the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is that spirit of holiness that we all share. Okay, so I'll get back to talking about forgiveness. So first step, identify the misperception. Second step, offer that misperception up to the Holy Spirit. Okay, third step, we wait to receive from the Holy Spirit within our minds the new perception. And sometimes you gotta wait a while. One of the things that came to me many years ago, and I like to say it, it took Jesus 3 days to rise from the dead. On the third day, he arose from the dead. So, yeah, you could give yourself at least 3 days to get a new perception about things that are really bothering you after you've actually turned them over consciously to the Holy Spirit. It's about not expecting the new perception immediately, because I think if you expect it immediately, it clouds or distracts you from actually asking. So the important part here is that you actually ask the Holy Spirit mentally, a mental question, or you mentally say something like, Holy Spirit, this perception of sickness that my friend seems to have, I know that's not the truth about them. I'm turning it over to you. Give me a new perception. And then you wait. But if you're expecting the new perception to come to you immediately, it tends to derail the asking of the question. So the important part is for us to ask the question. So ask it without an immediate expectancy of an answer, and then give yourself a while for the answer. But then when the answer comes, when you get a new perception that you feel is what Holy Spirit wants you to hold, then you got to hold it. You got to embrace it. And you got to claim it as your own. So that's the four-step forgiveness process that I believe is delineated in the Song of Prayer. So I'll review it. You know, you identify the misperception, you offer the misperception up to the Holy Spirit for correction. You wait for Holy Spirit to give you the correction. And then four, once you've received the correction, you got to embrace the correction and claim it as your own. That's forgiveness. Nothing else really qualifies. If the Holy Spirit is not involved in the process, it's not forgiveness. Forgiveness that the Course in Miracles asks us to practice always involves the Holy Spirit or the Christ. I mean, you can conceptualize it differently, But it's never something that we come up with ourselves. And I see it all the time. Course in Miracles students are trying to figure out what is forgiving by themselves. And that's not forgiveness. Forgiveness is joining with the Holy Spirit or joining with the Christ and asking for help. And that's the action. And that's what you need to do. And if you don't do it, you're not actually practicing forgiveness. In that passage that Reverend Elaine read, again, it was from the Song of Prayer. It says, when someone calls for help in any form, he is the one to answer for you. All that you need do is to step back and not to interfere. Forgiveness for salvation is his task, and it is he who will respond for you. So again, very clear, we don't do the forgiveness. Our job is to offer the misperception up to the Holy Spirit or to the Christ and let Holy Spirit figure out and give us the new perception, not to choose it ourselves. Also in that passage that Reverend Elaine read, it said, do not establish what the form should be that Christ's forgiveness takes. He knows the way to make of every call a help to you. So again, don't take over the process. Don't take over the Holy Spirit's job. It's his job. He's the one that makes the answer. He's the one that gives us the perfect answer that will be helpful for us. And we can't second guess it. Our job is to turn it over. That's the action that we have to do. Our job is not to come up with the correction ourselves. I do believe that all sickness, whether we see it in ourselves or whether we see it in others, contains a message for us, some important message for us. And we all want to understand the message, but it's not until we actually forgive that we will understand the message. And I believe the Course is quite clear about this. It says, the real world is the state of mind in which the only purpose of the world is seen to be forgiveness. And it is recognized that all things must be first forgiven and then understood. So we're never going to understand the message that an illness has, either an illness that we are manifesting in our own lives or maybe in our own bodies, or an illness that someone else is manifesting in their body and in their lives, or maybe it's an illness that the world as a whole or society is manifesting. But we're never going to understand what the message is until we forgive it. And remember, forgiveness is not accomplished by us. It's accomplished by the Holy Spirit or the Christ. The Holy Spirit or the Christ is what does the heavy lifting in the process. And I think this is what kind of upsets people. It seems like, the Holy Spirit's job is so much greater than ours. And it's like, we feel maybe insulted that we don't actually get to do the Holy Spirit's job. But that's the Holy Spirit's job. And we have to do our part. Our part is critically important. Our part is joining with that divine energy. And remember, the Holy Spirit is the spirit of holiness that we all share. It's not the entity's name. So we need to join with that holiness that is beyond our small sense of self. And we need to consciously, mentally ask for help and release our misperception and then wait for the answer and then embrace it when it comes. That is the action that we are being asked to do. And when we do that, we will get ideas. We will get the message that that sickness, that illness was trying to teach us. And we will get it because we joined with the Holy Spirit to find the answer. Forgiveness is an action, and we need to actually do it. We don't need to talk about it. We need to do our part. And we don't need to evaluate and think that our part isn't worthy. Our part is our part. Let the Holy Spirit, let the Christ do their part and practice true forgiveness the way A Course in Miracles teaches it. Okay, that's my talk for today. Thank you very much.
Nel nome del Padre, Figliolo, Spirito Santo. Amen.
Such a separation.
Have you been sad?